Boy, didn't get the message out, but I got a brand new ATPRO from Midwest Diggers, and I'm just learning how to use it. And I always noticed that some of my favorite detectorists, like that makes videos, like Exploring Alabama and She Detector, always said, "Ah, here's my target. Here's the number. And I know it's going to be a golden ring or a pull tab." That's my friend Exploring Alabama. He saves those pull tabs for his kids. I don't know if he tells them or not, but if they don't watch this video, they won't know. But he saves them for Christmas, and I'm going to do the same. And not for my, well, I don't have kids at home. I got grandchildren. So I think I'll save them and send them to him for his children. I know I'm going to get a bunch of them. Anyway, the idea was, since how this ATPRO is new to me, I was going to run over a Kennedy half, a clad quarter, a nickel, a dime, copper penny, and all that. I got a whole list of them. And if I did anything right at all, I might have gotten all of them on this video somewhere. Anyway, I'm going to try to get it all off and show it to you. I'll try to get it on my channel sometime this year, hopefully today. So here we go. We're going to try it now. Good luck to me and y'all. Hi folks, Cornbread Jack here. I wanted to test my new Garrett ATPRO detector. I wanted to see what the numbers would be on the readout for different coins and different metals. So I have a conglomeration of coins and metals, bullets. I even have that pure silver coin that's 0.999, 1 troy ounce, that Midwest Diggers gave me. A Kennedy half, clad quarter, a so-called gold dollar. This is a Garfield dollar. It's manganese, zinc, much more stuff. And then here's the clad nickel, the very famous pull tab. And this coin here, focus on it, is this little coin right here, is a Swiss coin with a 20 on the back of it. A copper penny, clad penny, and a clad rosy dime. Get my light just wrong here. Let's see, there it is. And starting back at the top, that's an empty 38 special shell, 9mm full loaded bullet, 22 bullet, with a copper jacket. And this coin right here, this right here is a bottle cap of some sort. I think it's not aluminum, might be brass. I think it's off of, what is that? It's off of maybe a whiskey bottle, don't remember. I think I dug it up. Dog tag, a steel nut. And this little clip right here is a linkage clip. It's a spring steel linkage clip from inside of a car door that I had left over. I want to take all these out, throw them on the ground. I wanted to bury them, but it's a little muddy today. I'll throw them out on the ground and run my new ATPRO over it. And then record the readings on those numbers. The reason I'm doing this is I always appreciate it when my favorite detectorists usually showed a sweeping, swinging, and when they got a target, they would say what the number is on that ATPRO. It always kind of gave me an idea of what I'd be looking for. So I want to go out, throw this on the ground, if it's not raining again, and then record each reading from each coin separately. So let's go out and do that. This is a ground I plan on using here. Should do the job fairly bare. Very quiet. I guess I better run my detector over that ground to see if there's nothing in there first. I'll be right back with it. Well, I've got this set up now I've got that Kennedy half a dollar set up. I call it out so you can see what I'm doing with this ATPRO. There's that Kennedy right there. I don't know if you can see it or not. 91.92 on the ATPRO. Clad quarter. 87. Solid 87 on that clad quarter. And here's that so-called silver, this is supposed to be a gold dollar. It's that new dollar, it's gold colored, sort of. Solid 86, 87. Or 87, 88. 86, 87. And this one here is the clad nickel, 51, 52. And over there is a steel nut. Jumping all over the place. I don't know what to call that. I'll give it to you in a minute. That steel nut over there drove this thing crazy. I got it set on Pro coins and 35 on the discrimination steel arm, whatever. Now we're going to go for the. This here is that coin from Switzerland. It's got a 20 on it. 49 or 50. Pull tab. The very famous pull tab. Can you guess what that is? It's a 53. Pull tab, 53. Same as a nickel. It's a little jumpy though. The pull tab a little jumpier when you got it on Pro coins. Settings on Pro coin. It's real jumpy, so you know the nickel's more solid like that. And that's what the pull tab sounds like. Now the pennies. Copper penny. 81. Copper penny. The clad penny. Little noise, it's a 75. That should tell you the difference between the clad and the copper. 75. Clad dime, 80, 81. And that's bottle cap. I don't know what that is. If it's aluminum, brass, what is it? 78. Dog tag, which I think is aluminum. 82. And here, how about this silver coin here? That sucker's 1 troy ounce, pure silver, 0.999. Excuse my sniffling. This raw weather about got me. Okay, 95. 95, just right 95 down there. Right in the middle of the page, right 99. And this here's 9mm bullet, 61. 9mm bullet, 61. 61. 38 caliber, 38 special, empty shell, 67. And that's aluminum, I think. It's a lightweight, it's not brass. And I've got a 22 here. That's brass or copper or something. 37 to 48, jumping around, 22 caliber loaded bullet, copper jacketed. And I think that's all I've got written down. Have I got anything else written down over there? A spring steel clip. Hold on, just a minute. I'll see if I can find that spring steel clip. Well, I can't find my spring steel clip. I'll give you something else. How about my keys? There's a whole batch of keys right there. If I ever lose them, this is what it's going to look like. 81, 80, 40, 78. Put 78, 82. 78, 82 for a batch of keys. I'm holding the detector about 2 to 3 inches off the ground. That's getting all my readings that way. I hope I can find everything else now after throwing it down there. There's my bullets. There's the other coins right there. Right through there. Did I get that dime down? Okay. Looks like I got everything. So I'm gonna. There's that copper penny. That's an 81. Okay, that's it. I'll try to get this loaded up. Okay, thanks everybody for being patient. Well, I don't know if you noticed or not, but while I was doing that little test with the ATPRO out there in the yard, I had a helper out there. Her name's Mama Dot. As Explorer Alabama always says, my bride. Well, I call her my vintage bride because she does have a few grandchildren. Well, she's got a passel of them. And I'm only responsible for the helping her get the children. And I'm not responsible for all those grandchildren, but I could be. They're all right in my book. Anyhow, I had her out there helping me put in the numbers to write the numbers down when I called them out. So thank her, Mama Dot, or Granny for the grandchildren, for helping me with the ATPRO experiment. I guess you'd call it that. And I thank everybody for putting up with my videos and my sniffling. I don't know if it's just from that raw weather we got or from allergies. They say the allergy is pretty bad now. Anyway, thanks to Exploring Alabama, his bride, and all their children. Oh, by the way, Alabama, in case I didn't mention it, I understand you really like those pull tabs, and I see someone sent you some the other day. I understand you save them for your children's put them in their Christmas stockings. So I'm going to do the same. I'm going to save all them pull tabs. Well, my children are not home, so I'll just send them to you so you'll have enough to go around. If you need more, let me know. I notice I find about as many as you do, and that's before I ever got an ATPRO. Oh, my goodness. I don't know what to expect now. Anyway, I'm happy to have the ATPRO, and I want to thank you for putting up with me. And say hi to your bride. And it's from my vintage bride to your bride. Maybe we'll meet one day. So long. See you later. Bye-bye.